around these people from now on forevermore. Those who trust in the Lord are like Mount Zion. We cannot be shaken, but forevermore. I'm gonna trust him. Those who trust in the Lord are like Mount Zion. Cannot be shaken, but forevermore. As the mountains surround Jerusalem, so the Lord surround his people from now and forevermore. Yeah, I will celebrate. I'll sing unto the Lord. I will sing to him a new song. Celebrate him. I will celebrate, sing unto the Lord. I will sing to him a new song. I will praise him. I will sing to him a new song. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. Ah, what a beautiful name. What a beautiful day. What a mighty God we serve. So excited once again to be on set with you people. I'm so, my excitement boys right from Sunday. You know, Sunday was quite, we celebrated my birthday as well as my wife's birthday together. And the response is quite, I don't know how to put it. If I say we've never seen such turnout, such show of love, such show of appreciation. We've never seen that before. We want to give God the glory for making it possible for us to go through that in Sandhead and in our commitment and dedication to Jesus Christ. What a privilege we have. So I want to use this opportunity, this chance, to acknowledge and appreciate as many of us who were able to be a part of our birthday celebration. We call it Papa and Mama's Day. It was on Sunday, on the 8th of November 2020. Glory be to God. I want to appreciate you sincerely from my heart. Glory be to God. And it's my prayer that, you know, God will do for you what you cannot do for yourself. God will bring into your life men and women that will help you get to the next bus stop of your life. People will help you joyfully. People will help you out of sincerity. And the Lord will bring them across your way. Between the end of this year, I am praying that testimonies you have never witnessed in your lifetime will begin to, you know, come into operation, come into full manifestation in your life. You will testify about the goodness of God in the land of the living, in the miracle working name of Jesus Christ. Welcome. This is once again Voice of Change, a production of Love of Flame Ministries, also known as the Champions Chapel. Our church is at kilometer 20, Navigate Okokomaiko Balagri Expressway, Okokomaiko, or your local government area of Lagos State, Nigeria. Glory. Excuse me. Praise God. We've been working so hard. We thank God for the opportunity. There's no other job I could have done the way I'm doing the job. Somebody called me yesterday and said, I've been watching you. I'm watching you. Don't you ever get tired? Don't you ever get tired? I said, no. Church on Air, which is like an online church, it's a privileged position God has accorded me, and I hold that position with my two hands, you know, and I, because we have testimony people, you know, calling in, people sending text messages who have been blessed by the reason of the Father we are on air. Even throughout COVID-19, I was preaching every day on air in spite of COVID-19, because COVID-19, Jesus Christ must reign on the face of the earth, because he shed his blood to purchase human being, to purchase mankind from the slave market of sin. And we have been given the privilege to herald, to talk about what Jesus Christ has done. And it's a rare privilege. And I thank God for it. So I am doing this thing not because of financial return or whatever. Whatever that is going on, the life of whoever that is watching me, any attack, any evil, I just sense it now. I don't know who you are. I decree God would respond and return it back to sender in the name of Jesus Christ. So we're not doing what we are doing because of financial benefit. No, that is not the major cause. The reason is because we are sent to do what you are doing. Jesus appeared unto me and told me, go and lead the world back to me. So I'm just playing my part. Many, many years ago, it was a vision. It was so clear that I cannot pretend not to have, you know, not to have seen him, not to have heard what he told me. I heard him. You know, some people who don't understand what these things are about think it's just for sure, for this. It's much more than that. Glory be to the Lamb of God. So I'm so happy to be back on air. And you remember last week, Friday, I began to share with us on learning to live by faith. I realized throughout my entire Christian life, I gave testimony last week on Friday when I was teaching on this subject of faith. I realized through my entire Christian life that the subject of faith, you know, whether I like it or not, is something I needed to, you know, something I needed to be using in my Christian life, whether I liked it or not. Amen and amen. So, and when the Spirit of God laid it in my heart to begin to share it, I realized everybody need to hear the subject of faith. And it's a subject that people think they know. So the topic I'm sharing on is learning to live by faith. It's a subject people think they know. They think, you know, every person goes to church, think they already know about the subject of faith. But we that are ministers of the gospel, haven't related with the body of Christ for many years, realize many people assume they know the subject of faith. Some people think they are living by faith, but the result they are getting in their life, you know, shows they have not really been living by faith. So I'm asking right now by the help of Holy Ghost to help us, for me to share the word of God, I'll be beneficial and a great blessing, you know, to as many that be watching me, those who are sick, those who need deliverance. God will break through this airwave and bring deliverance and bring freedom to your doorstep in the miracle working name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth. So what I'm sharing on it is learning to live by faith. I realize faith is a skill, spiritual skill you have to acquire. That's why the word learning is very important, because you could be in the Lord for 1 year, 2 years, 5 years, 10 years, and you really don't know what faith is all about in the practical terms of the word faith. And that's why on Friday I began to open us up to it. And from where I stopped on Friday, I'm beginning from there. You know, the Bible tells us in Hebrews chapter 11, verse number 6, what did he say? He said, but without faith, it is impossible to please him. And that him there is talking about God. You cannot please God without faith. You cannot bring glory to God without faith. Everything we do as children of God has to be something we do by faith. We live by faith. We talk by faith. We relate by faith. We reach people by faith. You know, talk to people about Jesus Christ by faith, expecting God to move in the life of people we are talking to, expecting changes, expecting, you know, transformation by the power of the word of God. You know, he said in Hebrews chapter 11, verse number 6, he said, but without faith is impossible. Now, listen to me. If faith is so crucial that without faith we can't please God, then the subject of faith is extremely crucial in our generation. In fact, if there's any time we need the subject of faith, it is now. Because Jesus told us, in Luke chapter 18, see, when I come back to the face of the earth, that is, when I come in the rapture to rapture the church, will I still meet faith on the face of the earth? Will I still meet people who are walking by faith? And you and I know, by the reason of what the world has gone through this year alone, it is a clear revelation that we need more than ever before to live by faith. Because most of the things we see, you know, it gives us an impression of a bleak future, gives us an inflation impression of a future that is uncertain. Even right now, you know, it's like they look as if things are not certain. You know, things are not the way they ought to be. Things are not working the way in most countries of the world, even where we are here in Nigeria and America at the moment are experiencing, you know, quite an upheaval in terms of, you know, election has become concluded, yet they have not been able to announce the true winner of that election. And that's to let you know this whole thing is happening all over the world. And if there's any time we need to live by faith, it is now. But without faith, we can't please God. In other words, if you really would want to please God as a child of God, as a genuine child of the Most High God, you would need faith. You would need to be able to live by faith. Because if you are not living by faith, the scripture is telling us clear, period, that you can't please God. And that brings it to the front burner, and that faith is extremely essential in a Christian life. That's why when you read the book of Habakkuk chapter 2, verse number number 4. What did he say? Habakkuk chapter 2, verse number 4. He said, behold, his soul, which is lifted up, is not upright in him. But he went further to say this, but the just shall live by his faith. Glory be to God. The just shall live by faith. You can see that without faith, we cannot properly live our Christian life. And faith is our ability to depend on God. Faith is our ability to trust God. Faith is our ability to accept the word of God as the final authority over any issue, over any matter of our life. Faith is depending on God. Faith is relying on God. Faith is counting God capable, counting God able. What man cannot do, as we believe God, as we trust God, he can bring such to pass in our life. That's what faith is all about. Glory be to the name of God. So this subject is very, very important. He said the just, Habakkuk chapter 2, we just read, verse number 4, revealed to us that the just shall live by his faith. The just shall live by his faith. That is to say, without faith, you cannot live your life, you know, profitably well. Without faith, you may not obtain profit on the face of the earth. Without faith, we are bound to find ourselves in different problems. And that's why Romans chapter number 1, verse 17 tells us, for where therein is the righteousness of God revealed. And it went further to say, as it is written, the just shall live by faith. We are called to a work of faith. Now, I was giving us an example of a man who walked by faith last week, Friday. I was talking about Abraham. Do you know what it takes for somebody to be waiting for about 25 years? He met God at the age of 75, and he was waiting for 25 years for the promised child to come. And this was God talking to him, and nobody has had an experiential knowledge of God before that time. So it was just a new experience. Abraham didn't know God. He's from an idolatry background, from a people that knew nothing about God. In fact, he was the one God used to start a nation of people he wanted to call his own before the coming of Jesus Christ. Abraham lived by faith. God gave him a promise of a child. Like God has given you a promise, you probably have seen vision, you have seen revelation, probably you fell into a trance, or maybe a prophecy like many years ago before I became a preacher. Most churches I attend, somebody will prophesy, I'm going to be a preacher. And God was already dealing with me anyway. I didn't tell anybody what God was telling me. But people would always prophesy. Maybe you have also gone through that trend in life of people prophesying this and prophesying that, or what your life portend, positively speaking, you know, in future. Listen to me. That was what happened to Abraham. And for those things to come to pass, you need faith. Nothing works except by faith. The just shall live by faith, as it is written. Romans chapter 1 verse 17 is the one speaking, that the just shall live by faith. As a just person, what does it mean to be just? Those who are born again. It's talking about the righteous one, the people who are into right standing with God. They needed to live by faith. So when God was speaking to me, people were prophesying. People said they saw me dream ministering. And personally, I began to pass through series of encounter with the Holy Spirit. The Holy Spirit began to give me certain training, certain understanding. I'll go to bed, I'll see some revelation that is so profound and so dumb. You know, most of the time when I see them, it's like I get dumbfounded. At the time, I was wondering, what was God wanting from me? What is it? What does he want? You know, I was a young convert, you know, a few months in the Lord. I was already seeing things. Sometimes I would see the heaven open. So many things happening that I just could not decipher. I could not put together. I didn't know why God should be so particular about me. Until I started going out, I go to church, people prophesy, they saw me preaching, all sorts of things was going on. And then God was dealing with me, you know. And in like manner, God is dealing with you right now. I think God wants me to shift to that. Now, whatever God tells you, listen to me, child of God. Whatever God tells you, either in dream or in vision, or as you were reading the Bible, a verse of scripture prop up to you, you know, telling you things that God wants to do, or maybe somebody prophesied, somebody gave you a word of knowledge, somebody gave you a word of wisdom, you know, over your life, God has spoken. Listen to me. Now, even though it hasn't happened now, that doesn't mean it will not come to pass. If Abraham could wait for 25 years for him to, I mean, and the time Abraham had a child, you read the book of Romans chapter 4, you will see what I'm talking about. The time Abraham finally got a baby boy, was, I think it was almost 100 years. And the wife also was, the wife had passed the age, the stage, and the age of menopause, was no longer experiencing what women experience. How could she be expecting the child? But because God has spoken, hallelujah, because God has spoken, and whatever God says, listen to me, he said, forever, O Lord, thy word is settled in heaven. That was Psalm 119 tells us. And you read the book of Isaiah chapter 55. He said, no word that has come out of my mouth will ever return to me void, without accompanying, without bringing to pass that which I've sent the word to accomplish. Are you getting what I'm talking about? In other words, if God has spoken to you and it looks as if it's been delayed, the Bible talks about hope deferred. In Proverbs chapter 13, verse 12, hope deferred, make the heart sick. It's like the thing is being delayed, it's being dragged and prolonged, and you are beginning to wonder it may not happen. Listen, God spoke to me. The first vision I had was in Zaria many years ago. I was a few months old in the Lord. Welcome to London. And it took about 20 to 22 years, if I can remember, to see that come to pass. When I got to London, some of the things I saw in that vision, in that revelation, were the things I saw in London. In that revelation, when I saw it 20, 22 years before that time, what happened was that Welcome to London was what was written behind the custom and immigration checkpoint in Heathrow Airport. And the first time I got to London, that was when I saw Welcome to London. Behind them was Welcome to London boldly written. That was a vision I saw 20, 22 years before it actually come to pass. And if I wasn't careful, I could have been tired. I could have been weary, wondering how could God be showing me vision that would take up to 20, 22 years to come to pass. And probably you are. That is not the message I wanted to teach, but I think I just sense the Holy Ghost is breaking through the airwave to talk to somebody who's watching me by the midst of this telecast. It's like you have been waiting for a word that has come to you from the Lord. You have been waiting for the manifestation, the physical manifestation, and it appears as if it's taking time. It's taking time to come to pass. God is saying that she encourage you that whatever he has spoken to you, either in secret or in public, very shortly, they are going to be manifesting. Now listen, the reason why sometimes God speaks to us and what God tells us, either in dream or in vision or somebody prophesied to us, does not come to pass immediately, is because God wants to prepare us before we get there. There are, listen to me, there are things God wants to do with your life, either in the business sector, in the educational sector, in the entertainment industry, or whichever sector of human endeavor you might be having an inkling, a desire to, you know, to influence and impact society in. I think God has spoken to you that we take time. God wants to take our time to work on your character, work on your person, work on so many areas of your life that you may not think are very important. Because sometimes we think, God, why are you delaying? But listen to me, the manifestation of a baby boy in the person of Isaac showed to us in the life of Abraham and Sarah that when God delays, because of the miracle he wants to bring to pass, and God really also wanted to show to the world through the life of Abraham and Sarah that age is inconsequential when it has to do with the manifestation of the promises of God. Glory be to God. It doesn't matter the age you are. You can still go back to school. It doesn't matter the age you are. You can still, you know, attain your vision. You can still pursue your dream. It doesn't matter. I was reading, was it a year ago or there about, you know, on the internet, and I saw the lady, you know, at age 83, this one was a white woman, is in the city of Liverpool, who had recently become a graduate, the first degree. And people, the interviewer was asking her, why did you at this age decide to go back to university? She said that was her childhood dream. She wanted to be a graduate. And earlier days of her life, she could not. Now that she had the means to do it, she still had to go to school, even though she knows she's quite old and the age is not her side. Glory be to God. That should let you know, whatever dream God has laid in your heart, whatever impression God has laid in your heart, whatever vision or idea God has placed in your heart, the time will come for them to come to pass. But you must submit to the training. You must submit to the mentorship that comes from the Holy Spirit. The Holy Spirit, who is the supreme commander of the army of God on the face of the earth, who want to work on your life, who want to build you up before the time come for the manifestation. I think that's the subject of this. One of these days, I will deal with that. What I'm actually sharing with us is to let us know God has called us to a work of faith. You see, the book of 2 Corinthians chapter 5 and 6, say, 7 rather, 5 and 7 say, for we walk by faith and not by sight. And listen to me, when you walk by sight, you are going to run into too many problems. Particularly today, the news that come from the news media, whether the mass media, the electronic media, whatever you may call it, internet, social media, and the rest of them, they are not very encouraging news. And if you are not careful, many people could suffer from hypertension, high blood pressure, because of the news that are coming. It's as if the world is being compressed. It's as if the kingdom of darkness is out to destroy. I just read a few minutes ago in the city of Mozambique, some wicked people just shouted Allahu Akbar and they killed about 50 people, slaughtered 50 people. That is the world we find ourselves. Every day you hear or see news that are not palatable, that are not encouraging. And sometimes even me, as a preacher, I sat down sometime early this year. I was asking, is it that this news were always there, or is it that they are just coming now because of the coming of Jesus Christ? Is that why evil seems to be multiplying on the face of the earth? Or what could be responsible for that? Or is it because we now have a social media platform where we can get to receive news and get to see news as it's breaking any part of the world? Somebody's already picking it and is posting it either on Instagram, on LinkedIn, on Twitter, on Facebook. Is it because of that? You know? And that's to let you know, news, evil news, are beginning to multiply on the face of the earth. And it may amaze you. God has called us to walk of faith. If we don't live by faith, many of us will suffer from medical problems because of fear, because of anxiety, because of worry. The atmosphere, there is a, particularly during the time of COVID-19, this part of the world, all you were watching on television was every day was COVID-19. You know, how it's moving, how it's killing people. And that alone is enough to cause problem, medical problem for people. That news alone, you know, bad news has a way of weakening the immune system of human being. You know, the Bible says a merry heart doeth good like medicine. In other words, when good news comes, it has a way of helping to rejuvenate our heart. It has a way of touching our human anatomy. It has a way of building us up. But evil news has a way of making our feet cast down. Evil news has a way of making our feet sad. That is why God is calling us to live by faith. The just shall live by faith. And where I just read 2 Corinthians chapter 5, verse number 7, tells us, he said, for we walk by faith and not by sight. And for example, when you see the word walk here, it's a metaphorical reference to the way a person conduct his or her life. We walk by faith. He's talking about how we conduct our life, how we live our life. It's a walk, because every day is a walk. You know, as we navigate our way through life, the scripture is letting us know we need faith to be able to navigate the map of our life as accurately as possible, so that we don't fall into too many problems, we don't fall into too many challenges. You know, we need faith. We need faith. So it's a metaphorical expression or reference to how we need to conduct our life, how we need to conduct our life, marriage, how we need to conduct our businesses, our career, and so on and so forth. So walking by faith means, even though you might not be able to see where you are going, you keep moving. That was what happened to Abraham. Abraham, I told you last Friday, Abraham was called out of a people of idolatry background. They were into fetish practices like it is in different part of the world. It was there God called him out to a walk of faith. You know, glory be to the Lamb of God. So walking by faith also means, even though we may not, we might not be able to see where we are going, yet we keep moving. That's what happened to Abraham. God called him out to a city, a place he doesn't have knowledge of, he had never been to before, but he moved out by faith. That's what faith is all about. You may not know how everything is going to end, but because you know you are walking by the word of God, you know it's going to end up in your favor. That's what faith is all about. Glory be to the Lamb of God. And what does it mean to walk by faith? When you are not walking by faith, for example, your daily life is controlled by worldly principles. You don't realize that you are moved by all the news, moved by all the report, you know. But unlike Paul, who tells us, he said, none of these things move me. Paul was not moved by what was happening. He went through diverse kinds of persecution and challenges, but he said, none of these things move me. Glory feet of the Lamb of God. So when you don't walk by faith, you are walking by worldly principle. You know, worldly principle tells us, you know, get all you can the can, and sit on the can. That is one of the worldly principles when it has to do with love, prosperity. They tell you, for you to make money, just get as many as possible, hold on to it, don't give to anybody. But the kingdom of God say, the principle of God's kingdom says, give and it shall be given unto you, good measure, pressed down, shaking together, run you. But if there is anything God has helped me, is the subject of giving, something God has helped to, it has helped me. When you give, it relieves you. When you give, you are happy. When you give, you know, you see the change, the facial countenance somebody you have given to, the way the person's face is lit up out of happiness and joy. How do you feel? Glory be to God. And that's what the word of God commands us to do. The Bible says, for God so loved, God so loved us so dearly, and because he loved us, he gave. That's what John chapter 3 tells us. For God so loved the world that he gave. So if you claim to love, giving must be a part of it. You know, lest I digress so far away. And listen to me. Walking by faith reflect the fact that we simply trust God in all things that happen in our daily walk, especially in regards to those things we do not understand. That's what walking by faith is all about. We simply trust God in everything that happens in our daily life, even when we don't understand. Now listen to me, it's not everything you understand. I am not an electrical engineer. So when you talk to how current move through the wire, how the positive and the negative work, I may not be able to give satisfactory explanation as to how it works. I don't know. Glory be to God. The subject of faith, you know, is also in that manner. There are things we don't understand. You know, faith, even though you don't understand, you dare to believe God. You know, you dare to believe God. He said he will keep those whose heart and mind are stayed on him. You dare to believe that, like David tells us, I was young now, old yet have I not seen the righteous forsaking, nor his seed begging bread. That is what this is all about. You know, as long as you're walking with God, you know, as long as you're serving God, God will not abandon you. Because he promised, he said, I will never leave you, neither will I forsake you. He said, I will be with you unto the end of the age. Glory be to the Lamb of God. So Abraham, even though he didn't have scientific explanation, he didn't have intellectual capacity to comprehend, or even spiritual capacity to comprehend what God was doing, where God was taking him, he dared to believe God. Can you dare to believe God today? Can you dare to believe God that between now and end of this year, things are going to get better in your life? Glory be to the Lamb of God. Can dare to believe God. Can dare to trust God that the current situation and challenges, or probably life crisis you are encountering at the moment, that God can make a way for you and bring favorable outcome. You know, the Bible says all things, Romans chapter 8, all things work together for good for to them that love the Lord and for to them that are called according to the purpose. Can you dare to believe God that because you are called according to God's purpose, that all things that are happening in your life, both the positive and the negative, will finally produce an outcome, you know, an ultimate result that will be satisfactory, that will make you rejoice in your life? Glory be to God. You can dare to believe God today. So walking by faith is walking by God's word. Walking by faith means, if this is what God's word says regarding this matter, I am going to live by that word, trusting God to perform it. Glory be to God. That's what it means to walk by faith. I will be continuing on this series by the grace of God on Friday. Tomorrow, I will be coming your way from our church platform, you know, and it's going to be powerful. This subject tomorrow, I'm sharing on the mystery of praise. You can, there are many the area of our Christian life that God has given us insight into. These are things that has helped me. I'm a musician. I like to worship God. I sing nearly all the time when I have the opportunity. Except when I'm praying or I'm busy. Even when I'm praying, I sing. You know, in between, I sing. Because if there's anything that helps to lighten your body, is power of praise. I'll talk about that tomorrow evening by 6 p.m. from our church platform. But I have been with us on Voice of Change, a production of Love of Flame Ministries, also known as the Champions Chapel. I told you our church address is at kilometer 20, Navigate Okokomaiko Badagry Expressway, Okokomaiko. Ojo local government area of Lagos State, Nigeria. Glory be to God. Peradventure, you want to have an easy access to watching me on air, you can go to www.loveaflameworld.org. Loveaflameworld.org. Then you can, we have point in our website where you can watch both the video and watch the radio. Because right now, as I'm communicating with us, I'm also communicating on radio. People are watching, listening on radio, just the way you are watching there, this channel. And when you go to our website, we just worked on it just few days ago. It's completely new. Everything there is breathing fresh air. You know, it's getting better by the day. Glory be to the Lamb of God. I want to pray for you that as the week progresses, God will bring progress into your life, bring increase into your life, bring fresh testimonies in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Excuse me. Praise the Lord. So by the grace of God, tomorrow we will be up on air by 6 p.m. also. And lest I forget, on the 6th of December, we're having our annual Thanksgiving celebration service. You know, there's anything we need to do this year is to celebrate God. Because many of us, with the way COVID-19 engulfed the world months and months ago, it was as if nobody was going to be left standing after the ravaging effect of that deadly disease. But God has kept you and I alive. And I know that same God would ensure his blessing locates you wherever you are and cause his face to shine on you in the miracle working name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth. Dear viewers, this is how far we can go today, because I realize it's better we have short teachings and discussion than long discussion. So by the grace of God, tomorrow is going to be between 40, 45 minutes. I'll be on air from 6 p.m. So hook up with us and we are going to be on air. Until I come your way once again, let me leave you with this. Remember that it can only get better in your life because your worst days are over. Please help to share this on your Facebook page. And also, like, go to our YouTube and like our YouTube channel is Amazing God TV. When you get in there, you see most of the things. You can subscribe to it. Let's get to know you. Glory be to God. God bless you. In Jesus' mighty name. Amen.